Hey guys, and welcome to day 4 of the flats and hand washing challenge of 2021. Today's video topic is favorite flat folds and diapering systems. So let's hop in. So today's video is totally real mom life. I have like pretty much no makeup on. The bed is totally not made. I haven't shut the doors behind me. Everything is just a mess and I'm sitting here on the floor. I'm gonna show you how I fold up these diapers on the floor. So let's just see exactly what I've been dealing with. So I do have two different kinds of diapers. I have a rectangular newborn size flat from Green Mountain Diapers. And then I also have the traditional square flats. I have some Elemental Joys and the Bird's Eye from Green Mountain Diapers one size. So I have three different types of diapers that I'm using, but two different shapes of flat diapers. So first here I want to show you, this is one of the muslin newborn size flats. You can see we got some stains on there, but I've been folding those into kind of a diaper bag style. So I will show you how I fold that up. Okay, so this is the diaper bag fold for the half flat here. So you can see it's a big rectangle instead of being square. It's not square, it's rectangular. So I take it and fold halfway in on one side, halfway in on the other side, and then I fold about a third, one third up here. And this just depends on how big your baby is. So if your baby is a little bit older, you might go down more. If your baby's even tinier, you might pull it up a little bit more. But right now for my 1 month old, that's a good size for him. And then you fold it in and then you like splay out the back part, fold in the bottom part and let the back part stay open. So that will be where baby's butt goes. And you just fold this up and snappy it right onto baby. Then I also have the Bird's Eye one size from Green Mountain Diapers. So this is the square flat, and I also fold my Elemental Joys like this. This is a Joe fold for the diaper, and I'll show you how I fold that up. Here we have the Joe fold. So for a Joe fold, it's a little bit messy here, but let me show you. So you're starting off with your big flat. You don't necessarily have to start off in a diamond shape, but you're going to be folding each section in to create a little square in here. So you're folding each corner inside, inside, and then depending on how big baby is, once again, you might need to make it a little bit smaller. Like I said, it's kind of messy. It's not exactly straight here. But then you're going to fold in and let the back go out. Fold in the bottom and let the back go out, and then baby's butt goes right here. The nice thing about this particular fold is if you fold down your last section as your butt section, I guess, is that it's all one big piece of fabric right here. You don't have folds and stuff getting, like, the poo is just going to be right on this solid piece right here. You're not going to have like a random fold here where you've got poo on this part and poo on that part and you have to like wash separate parts of the diaper. You're going to get poo right here on this one layer, and then you can like clean it off of that. I know we're talking about cloth diapers, so we're going to mention poo, but but it's just kind of convenient to not have to worry about poo being on like different parts of the diaper. It's all just like contained right on this layer. Now, I used to really love the origami fold, but I'm not digging it with Barrett being so small. He's only 1 month old, and he's the only one that I'm cloth diapering during this challenge. He's the only one who's still wearing diapers. Well, of course, he's still wearing diapers. He's only 1 month old. So I used to really love the origami fold, and I do like it on bigger kiddos. When I cloth diapered my first two sons, I used the origami fold quite a lot. But this time around on Barrett, he's only 1 month old, and I don't find the origami fold to really work super awesome on his little body. I just don't like the way that it's just a little too big on him, and it's just kind of funky and not as clean and neat as these other folds that I was showing you guys. But the cool thing about an origami fold is you don't always have to use a fastener or a snappy. The wings are so large that you can just kind of tuck them into each other and it just will stay on baby. So it is kind of convenient in that way. But like I said, just on such a tiny little body, Barrett's only 1 month old, it's not as nice as some other folds. So here is the origami fold. I know it's kind of scary when you first see it. You want to fold in half, fold in half again, and then you're going to take this corner here that's loose. You don't want one of the folded corners, like how this is wrapped around. You want like just the single layer, and you're going to pull it out until you've got this big old triangle, and then you're gonna do the hard part. You have to flip the whole thing over, and you can fold up this middle section however you like. So you can do thirds if you have a bigger baby, so the crotch section is a little bit wider. Or for me, since I have a little baby, a 1 month old, I like to fold over once and fold over again. So that's in fourths right here. And then I like to tuck these under just to make it a little more narrow in the crotch section. So baby's butt will go right here, and you'll just fold this up on him. And then you can see these tabs, these wings for the waist are really big. So you can really just like tuck that underneath and then come over here and tuck it under the leg here so it stays on baby without having to use a snappy. But that's one of the really cool things about flats is that you can switch it up all the time. If you tried a new fold this week, you can do a new fold next week. Next time you do laundry, you can do something totally different. Or you don't have to really fold anything. You can just make it into a rectangle pad and throw it in a cover. And speaking of pad folding, we did try to do pad folding for the nighttime diapers, but I've kind of given up on that because the first day we did it, Barrett pooped and got it on two covers. And I only have four covers for the challenge. So first thing in the morning, I had to hand wash two covers in the sink already, like right off the bat during the challenge. And so I was like, maybe we should be folding. Cause if you're actually, you know, wrapping this around the baby and snappying it shut and then putting the cover on top of that, you've got like two layers of protection before poo escapes their diaper. But if you're just pad folding it, the pad is just taking up the middle section of the diaper, and you're going to end up sometimes getting poo on the cover. So we totally got poo on the cover, two covers, that first night that we tried just pad folding. And I wanted to do pad folding because I know my husband doesn't necessarily like folding and using snappies. It's just not his favorite thing. And he does do, most of the time he'll do at least one of the diaper changes overnight through the night with Barrett. And so I wanted to use pad folds for my husband's sake, but since it just got on the cover twice, I have kind of given up on that. So hopefully my husband's not too angry about having to actually wrap a flat around the baby at like 2 o'clock in the morning. And of course, I think everyone knows the pad fold. So you're just gonna fold it in half. And then depending on how big baby is, you may have to kind of finagle this. So you might have to fold like in thirds or something, and then fold it up until you have a little pad shape to stick inside of a cover. So pad fold is super duper easy. And of course, once again, like all flat folds, you can customize it if you need it to be a little bit smaller for your particular baby size, or even if you need it to be longer, you can just do something like this so that you keep the most of the absorbency up here at the front. I have boys, so I like to have the absorbency up here at the front. And then you've got like a little bit less here if you need it to be extra long. So yeah, those are the folds that I've been using this time around. I hope you guys liked this video. Maybe you learned something different. Maybe you learned how to fold one of those rectangular shaped flats a little bit better. I know it was kind of difficult for me to figure out exactly what fold I wanted to be using for that particular newborn half flat. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. If you did like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out all the links down below to the flats challenge stuff that's all down there. I hope you guys enjoyed. I think I said that like three times now. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.